This is the sixth part of our second semester's first prose, and that is What is the Rain, which is written by William Slimer. So, open page number 31, last paragraph. Long ago, in the First World War, now here the writer is giving description about First World War. When I was a bit more irresponsible, so that time writer was in the force, in military force, and that time he was not responsible, he was very irresponsible person. I served under an officer of vivid imagination. Vivid, it means unnecessary or excessive concern. He was always fusing about danger that usually doesn't exist. So he was always trying to tell, trying to think, trying to worry about a danger situation, and actually but there was not any kind of danger situation according to the writer. Once after a day and half a night of his constant alarms, alarm it means a warning, a warning of danger. I was so fed up. Fed up, it means annoyed or bored. Fed up that I disconnected the telephone in the advance post I was holding. So continuously, that day, that particular day, and till the half night, the officer was giving warning again and again about the danger, that something danger going will definitely happen here. And that time, the writer was at the first advanced post, at the starting post of military force. So, again and again, the caution, the warning was given about danger, therefore the writer felt very annoyed, very bored, therefore he disconnected the telephone. I wanted some sleep. Why? Because writer wanted some sleep because he was alive from long time. I didn't get it. Within half an hour, his imagination had painted the most frightful picture. Frightful, it means dangerous, of my position, overrun, it means occupy, it means take control on, by the enemy. And whatever the imagination the officer was having, that imagination was going to be true that particular night when the writer disconnected the telephone because he wanted some kind of sleep. And particularly that night, the enemies attacked on the forward post and the enemies started to fire, started to take control of that forward post. He arrived with the reserve company to retake it. And when the officer knew that enemy started to take control that forward post, that time that officer came with another force that was reserved and started to take control again on that post where the enemy came to take control. As he was my commanding officer, I had some rather difficult explanation to do. So, when the commanding officer asked writer how this happened and what were you doing, that time the writer was not ready to give good explanation of all the situation. I thought he was just windy. Windy it means? Anxious or nervous. Windy. A few days later, he won the VC by super example of leadership and courage. So, that time the writer was thinking that his officer was a windy person, very anxious person, very nervous person. But after a few days, that officer won the VC, very prestigious award in the military force. And for what? Because the good leadership, good example of leadership and courage. Next paragraph. Again, in this last war in Burma, a young Gurkha on the VC. So again, in the last war, it means Second World War in Burma, a young Gurkha soldier on the VC award, Veer Chakra or any other name. At a critical moment, critical it means judgmental. When Japanese medium tanks had broken through our forward position, he took his PR, that's an anti-grenade discharger. Discharger it means anti-tank launcher, and leaving cover moved forward for the open towards the tank. So in that war, when Japanese medium tank started to take control on their forward position, that time this Gurkha young soldier took his PR, and that was the anti-tank grenade launcher, and went forward to attack those medium tanks, to destroy those medium tanks. He was shot in the hand, the soldier, and again badly in the leg. So first, when he came forward to attack on those tanks, he was first shot, had a bullet in his hand, in his arm, and next another bullet he has in his legs. But he got to within 30 yards of the tank and he pumped off two of them. Bump, it means blow. Blow or exploded. So he needed to go within 30 yards. Because within 30 yards he knew that he can destroy any tank. Therefore, he went forward to go within that distance. Then he can throw that anti-tank grenade on that tank, and he wanted to destroy those tanks. Later, when I saw him in hospital, I asked him why he had walked forward in the open like that. So when he was admitted in the hospital, that time writer went to ask him to see him that why he did this kind of daring, why he went forward to attack on those tanks, because we all know that if you go forward, then automatically the other Japanese soldiers will shoot you, will kill you with their fire bullets or with their guns. He replied. Then that Gurkha soldier gave reply to the writer, I had been trained not to fire the piyut until I was certain of hitting. So that Gurkha gave answer that he was trained to attack on those tanks. When you are fully confident that you are in that space, you are in that distance, that you can attack on that tank, you can destroy that tank, that time you can do that kind of daring and go forward and destroy that tank. This kind of training was given to me. I knew I could hit at 30 yards. So I went to 30 yards. So that Gurkha soldier told the writer that he knew that if he go in the distance of 30 yards, so he can definitely destroy that tank, and he knew he can do that. Therefore, he went forward to destroy those tanks. I knew I could hit at 30 yards, so I went to destroy yard. He had only one thought in his head to get to 30 yards. Quite simple if you aren't bothered by imagination. So he completely knew that if he went into the 30 yard distance, he will definitely destroy that tank. That only thought was in his mind, therefore he did that kind of daring, that kind of courage. So quick simple, if you aren't bothered by imagination, so if you are not bothered, worried by any imagination, then you can do any problematic situation very simply. So in this way, student, this part ends here. We are going to stop here. Have a good day to all. Thank you.